So there's various forms of funding. We're looking at funding green infrastructure. There's funding available at the planning stages, at the construction stages, programs like Towns for Tomorrow and the New Building Canada Fund. And there's recognition, an annual award program to recognize communities across British Columbia that are becoming more green and more sustainable. The Infrastructure Planning Grant Program has been in existence for several years. The grants are up to $10,000 each, and I'm sure we all realize that $10,000 doesn't go quite as far as it used to, but you can apply for more than one. So I would encourage you to do that. You can look at phasing a project or even breaking it up into pieces so that you might be applying for two or three or four grants at the same time. The next deadline intakes is expected to be in the end of January, after which they will be awarded. There are some ideas here for you to think about in terms of planning grants. You might look to doing a stream health feasibility study, maybe starting on your watershed management plan. Perhaps a community creek or stream could be looked at in terms of its catchment area. You might be able to study locations where you can put in rain gardens or where you can develop pathways along streams and shorelines to protect those riparian areas. The planning grant program is one of the few programs that we have that is not always oversubscribed. So if you do want to do even some small levels of planning in your community, I would certainly encourage you to apply.
Could you apply for a relook at OCP based on a watershed plan then?
I think so. I don't see why not. If you want to talk about it in detail, you know, call our office. But I don't see why not. There are some things that people are looking at improving ways that they've done things before. So I can't see why not. I mentioned the New Building Canada Fund. It's a provincial federal shared program. It's available now. Applications are being accepted until the end of September, the end of this month. There will likely be a second intake, but I would certainly encourage you to apply if you have projects that are pretty much ready to go. Rainwater, which you've been hearing this morning, is an eligible project. Stormwater, projects to improve the quality and manage the quantity better. As well, drinking water and wastewater projects are eligible. Provincial grant programs typically support applications that identify things like these on the list. This is an important slide for you in doing applications for infrastructure funding. These are the sorts of things that we are looking for in order to prioritize projects. These programs are always oversubscribed. There's a huge number of people who would like to get those less expensive dollars. So we're looking for applications that identify how a community and a project will minimize the hydrologic footprint, how low impact development is included, how sustainable principles are managed and incorporated into the project and into the community. Things like reducing the demand on resources and conservation, and recovery and reuse of resources. We look for how a project supports provincial plans, guidelines, strategies, things like the Living Water Smart strategy that's been discussed. And we're looking to encourage innovation and looking for projects that might generate knowledge that can be transferred across the province to other communities. I think this is a relatively new focus for infrastructure programs, and the hope is that the government will be sharing some of the risk associated with doing more innovative things. Kim mentioned this project in Butte Royal, which is near Victoria. It's a $7.4 million project, but really what it is a highway project. The highway runs directly through the main part of town. So rather than building a four lane and moving the congestion to the ends of that four-lane section. They decided to handle rainwater by building rain gardens, and also they'll be building trails for bikes and pathways for pedestrians along the sides, and making the route more suitable for buses to encourage people to get out of their cars and to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. So today, projects under the infrastructure programs are open in the eligible categories. Assessment is focused on the greener the project, the greener the community, the better. And all projects from water and wastewater from communities must have a water conservation plan in place. As we move forward, projects are only going to be eligible where they are green and sustainable. There's going to be a need for strongly support communities and projects that strongly support green infrastructure and sustainable approaches. And there's going to be a condition that a community be undertaking a watershed management plan. So this is where we see that today's expectations, some of the things that we're talking about today, are going to be tomorrow's standards. So some new rules are coming for assessment of infrastructure projects. We'll be looking for integrated rainwater management approaches like those that are being talked about in this series. We'll be looking for adaptations to climate change to be identified in the project and in the community, reduction of greenhouse gas emissions. We'll be looking for sustainable programs such as asset management in communities. And we'll be looking for wastes to be viewed as resources, whether that's heat recovery and energy generation, or simply reuse of some of the resources that used to be discharged. As well as infrastructure grant programs, there's also the recognition program, Green City Awards. And communities around the province are going to be getting annual funds, recognizing those communities that are moving towards becoming more green and doing things more sustainably. So I hope you see a little bit about how some of the rules are we're changing some of the rules to serve the goals. We're looking to adapt to climate change and reduce the ecological impact of all of our communities. So we hope that you will identify the ways that your communities are doing that when you're making applications under infrastructure plan programs. Questions?
You mentioned communities must have a water conservation program in place. That's at this point in time.